Objective 2 of topic 1 is the transformations of radical functions. So we just got done talking about the parent function y equals the square root of x and cube root of x. And now we're going to look at how these graphs move around based off that parent function. All right. So I've listed 4 steps in blue that we're going to take to do this. I'm going to initially find the vertex of the given function and plot it. Then I'm going to draw a sketch of the new function based off this vertex, describe the transformation based off the vertex, and then find the domain and range. Alright, so if you notice, the vertex is very important in this process, and that's why I'm going to find it first. I can find a lot of things, really all 4 of these things can be found based off that initial vertex. So if I'm going to do number 4, if you remember way back when with module 2, vertex form of a quadratic equation, same thing exists here, alright, vertex form of a radical equation. Now, the x value of the vertex sits within the radical function with that x. Sometimes it'll be there, sometimes it won't. In this case, it is there. The x value of the vertex is trapped inside that radical with the x. Now, if you remember, though, the x value to the left, so the left number, if you notice, there's 2 numbers here, negative 1 and negative 5. The left number is always lying to you. The x value of the vertex within that equation is always lying to you. So it's a negative 1 within the vertex. It is a positive 1 it's a negative 1 within the equation. It's a positive 1 as I write my vertex. Now, so the x value is lying to you. The y value is telling the truth. So the y value will always be as it's written in the equation, all right? I don't know why. Oh, yeah. But, wait for it. It can be considered k, but I'm just going to say y. The x value of the y value transforms into the x and y value of the vertex. But again, the x value is lying to you. Now, the transformation in words. But before that, I can draw a rough sketch of this. I'm going to plot my vertex over 1 down to negative 5. And if you remember from the parent function, I went over 1, up 1, over 4, up 2, over 9, up 3, based off of the perfect square. So I'm going to go do the same thing. Over 1, up 1, over 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, up 2, and then I can just estimate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, up 1, 2, 3. There is the new function based off of the parent function, y equals the square root of x. So the y equals the square root of x minus 1 minus 5 is the graph in green, all right? And from there, I can discuss the transformation in words. It shifted. To the right, 1. One space, and down 5 spaces. Now, please be advised, at times it will also flip about the x-axis, but that's only if there was a negative out front. If there's ever a negative out front of these functions, then they would flip about the x-axis. So if that was negative, don't draw this, just look at this. If it was negative, it would go down like that, all right? It would flip about the x-axis and go, instead of going up and to the right, it would go down and to the right. But this one's not negative. That was just, you will see some negative ones in your practice, so just be aware of that. And then finally, let's finish this off. The domain. Now, the domain is not going to be all real numbers here, all right? This is a new learning, technically. The domain is always based off the x value of the vertex. If you remember, domain is always x values. So the x value of the vertex is 1. So I'm going to write 1 there. Domain is left to right motion. So if you notice, the leftmost point of this graph is that dot right there. And the x value at that dot is 1. This is 1 comma negative 5, the vertex, all right? So the domain starts at 1, the leftmost point. And in this case, like always, this arrow means it goes on forever. So the domain will go from 1 to positive infinity. That is my domain. Please box in that 1 because it's included. If you notice, this dot is closed, So I have to use a bracket instead of a parenthesis by that one. Now, the range is similar to the domain. Sometimes the range will be a little trickier, especially if it's negative, because then you'll start with negative infinity, but it goes from the lowest point to the highest point, floor to ceiling. The lowest point of this graph, if you'd notice, the leftmost point of the domain was the x value of the vertex, so the lowest point of the range is the y value of the vertex. So I have to bracket that because we include that value. And just like this arrow goes to the right forever, it also goes up forever as well. So the range is negative 5 to positive infinity. But please be advised, again, if it was a negative function and it would go down and to the right, that would affect the range, okay? So you'll see that in your practice problems. Let me see if I can find one of those. Now, with the cube root, I will do an example of the cube root as well. It's the same process. You find the vertex. So if number one right here, this is the x value of the vertex, this is the y value. So, but remember, the x value is lying to you, so it was a positive 6, now it's a negative 6. And the y value is telling the truth, negative 2. So this is the vertex of this cube root function. So I go over to negative 6, down to negative 2, draw my vertex. Now, to draw this sketch, we can base it off of the graph. The pattern was, I would go over 1, up 1, over 8, up 2. So I can go back to that and draw that roughly. I can go over 1, up 1, over 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up 2. And I'm counting based off the vertex. But if you notice, this one goes, so I can go to the left 1, down 1. But then negative 8 is somewhere over there. So I don't care as much about the accuracy of these graphs that you're drawing. I care more that you understand the domain range and the transformations that exist based off the vertex. So I'm going to draw the vertex in green there. So the transformation that happened, it shifted left 6 spaces this time, and down 2 spaces. Now, for cube root functions, if you notice, this goes to the right forever and up forever. This goes to the left forever and down forever. That will be the case for every cube root function. So the domain and the range are both all real numbers. All right, so I give you 4 practice problems to try. Please try all 4 of these, stating the vertex, drawing a sketch of it, telling me in words what the transformation is doing, and then also the domain and the range. Now, be advised, number one on this page is negative. So instead of going up and to the right, it should go down and to the right. Good luck.